If you are new to Simumatik and you don't know where to get started, don't worry, because in this video we are going to give you a quick introduction. Hi, my name is Mikel and welcome to the Simumatik channel. Don't forget to subscribe and read the description below if you want to get more information. If you enjoy the video, please give us a like. To start using Simumatik, you don't need to install anything. You just need to navigate to our web, simumatik.com, and start creating an account. You can do it by clicking on this button or the sign up button here in the middle of the website. If you already have created an account, you can just jump to the app, web app, clicking the login button. Again, here you can navigate between the sign up and the login forms, but when you have the account created, you just type your email address and your password and you are all to go, good to go. Remember also that if you don't want to create a specific account for Simumatik, you can also use the Google account or a Google account. But let's log in and jump into the Simumatik web app. And from the website, you will need to click and go to platform. But just a tip, you can just type app.simumatik.com and then you will come directly to the app. So you don't need to go through the website. Because this is a web app, it's gonna update automatically each time Simumatik releases a new version, so you don't need to worry about any updates or upgrades. And once you enter the app, you will come to the welcome page or start page. Here you will see a card with your name and your actual plan. Individuals have basic or free plan and the standard or paid plan, as is the case. And then if you have assigned a seat in an organization, you will see other cards shown at the right of your private card. When you access the platform as an individual, you will be able to create your own systems and components, private components just for you, and then you decide if you want to share them or publish them for the community. But when you access the platform using an organization, then you will get full features of the platform and also the possibility to collaborate with other members in those organizations. Let's go ahead as an individual or private user. And the next thing you need to select is where you want to run the models. So you have two options here. You can download what we call the local workspace or the local server, which will allow you to run the models locally. That's a good option when you don't want to use a lot of internet connections. So yeah, everything is run locally. You just need to have an internet connection to download and upload any changes to the cloud. But if you are on a run on another computer, or you just want to access quickly for a demo or whatever the workspace, you can use the online workspace. This means that we are going to launch an instance, a computer instance in the cloud, and you are going to be using that computational capabilities in the cloud to run the models. But it will require a better internet connection. It's going to be like an online game, video game. So you will be kind of communicating all the time to see what's going on with the model. So let's go ahead with the local workspace. I already launched the app. So now we are here in the workspace. It's a pretty simple app. We have at the left side the panel where we can browse systems and their content, create new systems or load the existing ones. Here we have the top toolbar where we can handle the basic stuff we need to do with the with the system, and here on the top right we have a shortcut to the user manual, and we can manage our account or exit the app whenever we want. So let's start by creating, or by loading a public system in Simumatik, because it's a cloud-based platform. Anyone, any user can create a system and then share it with the community. So when you decide to load a system, you can search by your private systems or public system, and in that case you can just make a simple search or just browse what is available. In this case we are gonna open a system which is called a quick start demo, and then when you select it you can just see the description. You can actually enter the system page or load it, which is what we are gonna do now. The system is being downloaded from the cloud and instantly loaded to the workspace. So this is the system itself. We can click on any component in the system and it will be selected here as well. So here, this is what we call the system tree, where we see systems or components group in assemblies, and we have options to do with each of the elements here in the tree. And when we select it on the tree, it becomes selected in the 3D area, and vice versa, when we select a component in the 3D area, it is selected as well in the tree. When we select a component, we will see here that the panel, property panel and the port panel appears. And basic operations like moving components, we do it with this tool selected, in which case we can just move components in one axis, up and down, right, left, or in a plane. And then we can select this tool instead if we want to rotate the elements. If you want to make a more accurate positioning or rotation, you can use this helper in the lower part. So if we just want to rotate it 90 degrees, we can just round the valleys here and we will get a more accurate rotation. And basically the other stuff we can do is just click play, so it will start the emulation. And in this case you see that beverage cans are dropped in this blue cone. At any time we can pause the emulation and then continue with it, or we can reset it at any time, which will take everything to the initial state. In this very simple system, we have just two buttons. One, as you will see, to activate the conveyor. So now with the button pressed, the cans will go forward, we move forward until they hit the cylinder here in the front. We can at any time release the button and it will stop. And with the green button, we can extend the cylinder, as you see here. So at this point, if we extend the cylinder completely, the products will drop down and you see them rolling around. What we are gonna do now is just add a little component here to keep all the cans on it when they fall down. So we are gonna click on add component. And here again, we can search for our own private components, or we can search for public components that other community members have created and shared with us. We do it through the libraries, which is also a set of grouping components that we will describe in other tutorials how to do. So let's search in this library called products, and we have here plastic box component that we can use. This is totally public and you can add it to any system, and we just give it a name. We can just call it box, and now it's been downloaded and introduced into the system. So actually the component is here in the middle of this group, this assembly, and we are going to position it here. We are going to rotate it 90 degrees accurately here, and let's move it a little bit to the left. And once here we can click on play, start the conveyor, so we make sure we push all the cans to the right, and now whenever we want we can press the green button, which will extend the cylinder, and when we have all our 10 cans here, you see how we can drop them and they actually ended up inside the blue box. So this is how you interact with the system. At any time, if you prefer to have a more immersive view, you can click on this icon and you hide the panels, and you can still play with everything. And that's all. So if you want to try another system, you can just click close here and it will clean up the workspace, and then you can start searching for any other tutorial and get some inspiration and learn how to use our platform. As you see, it's very easy to get started in Simumatik. There is a lot of public systems to explore, and in fact in Simumatik we have created many tutorials to get started with PLC programming or robotics. So if you have any comments or suggestions, let us know, and see you in the next video.